And here we go. Yay, we get to go get on the shuttle. There we go. Guess we had to land a shuttle. Makes sense, land a shuttle.
Shuttlecraft, this is Vulcan Orbital Control. You are clear to land at the requested coordinates. Welcome to Vulcan, please.
Ooh, someone's a little drunk flying their shuttle. Hey now, don't crash. Jesus. And up and up and up and up. Don't kill the monk. Probably bad if we kill the monks, huh? Probably lose the game. Probably say, "Hey, you're not worthy to be captain no more. Goodbye." And that's all she wrote. Hey, Ambassador,
dude.
The guy water has a long run up them through the desert.
Do you have any questions? My business is my own. If you must know more, I require a meeting with the Abbot. He will not use subspace communications. So if I am to receive his counsel, I need to meet with him directly. Do you have any questions?
No, let's get...
This is ridiculous. Access to Pajem is strictly limited to preserve the sanctity of the monastery. No outsiders are permitted to land without the expressed permission of Savin, the leader of the Order of the Priest that maintains the planet. Ordinarily, this would not present any difficulty, but Savin has chosen this moment to illogically question my visiting the monastery. He is refusing to grant leave for me to meet with the Abbot at Pajem. If I do not complete my journey to Pajem now, I will have to delay it until after the trade conference at Corridon is complete. And that could take weeks. I fear I've spent too much time off-world. While I find it easy to deal with others, my own people can be... stubborn. Perhaps you could speak to Savin. I know he has a great deal of respect for Starfleet, and you might have an easier time than I have.
Yo, Savin, dude. Yo, yo, yo. The hell you doing? Screwing up my mission. I don't have time for your bullshit.
Peace and long life.
I'll show you peace and long life.
Knowledge of the ancestors. Sarketh accuses me of abandoning logic, but he is the one refusing to explain his reasons for wanting to go to Pajem. The planet is sacred. Our ancestors walked those paths. They found understanding and serenity in its quiet. When I am at Pajem, I feel more at peace than any place else in the galaxy. Pajem has been touched by outside influences in the past.
Freaking getting ready to get blowed up, so you better let someone go there, yep. Pointy-eared, long-bearded crack nugget.
Do you seek knowledge of the ancestors? Centuries ago, the Vulcans were creatures of emotion. We fought one another in a series of wars that devastated our planet. Our species was on the brink of annihilation. Sirach,
well, it's because you're stupid and won't let us complete our mission. How the hell am I going to finish my game if you won't let me complete the gosh dang mission?
His writings, Kirshara, shaped all that we are. Without Sirach, the Vulcans, you know.
Blah, blah, blah.
Do you seek knowledge of the ancestors? The monks do not use any unnecessary technology. Even replicators are not permitted on the gem.
Well, what the hell do they eat if they can't have a replicator? You crack nugget people. You pointy-eared crack nuggets.
Do you seek knowledge?
No, I don't seek knowledge. I want to continue on.
I will permit it if you will pledge to me on your honor as a Starfleet officer that you will protect Pajem from harm. Soketh says his reasons for wanting to speak to the Abbot are private. I will accept that, but only if you are with him. I know I can trust Starfleet. Please, protect Pajem from any who would violate its sanctity.
Back over to this crack nugget, pointy-eared crack nuggets.
Do you have any questions?
Why don't he trust you?
He is a small man with small concerns. Thankfully, he has listened to reason, and our journey won't be delayed any longer. I am ready to leave now. Is the shuttle prepared for departure?
I reckon it is. Back to the shuttle! Yay! Jump, jump! Jump, jump! Hey look, it's my shuttle! Jump, jump! Hey, pointy-eared dude. Sure, you got some funky-looking bushes? They look sort of fake-like. The hell you guys grow here? Pointy-eared bushes. Get on the shuttle.
Starfleet shuttlecraft, we have logged your flight trajectory, and you are cleared for departure.
Yay! Frickin' I'll live a lot longer if you guys just let the people go that's supposed to go. Woo, woo. Okay, you pointy-eared dude, where are we headed?
And prepare for my meeting with the Abbot at Pajem. If you have no objections, I will retire to my quarters. Please notify me when we have arrived at our destination. Once again, you have my gratitude for your assistance.
Okay. Return to the bridge. I'm out in the middle of space. Quick, jump out. Hey, there we go. Jump out into space. That's a good plan. We're full of good plans today. Good, let's get out of this place. Oops. No! God dang it. Yay. Now we gotta deal with the...
You have a foul shape changer aboard your ship. Turn the creature over to us, or we will destroy you. That foul beast on your ship is an Undine. They put on a false face and try to control us, but we Klingons know better. We will hunt them down.
Great. There's always something that's gotta be wrong. Why can't they make this simple?
My patience is limited. Speak quickly. You tell me, Starfleet. It was your people who first encountered the Undine in the Delta Quadrant back when we knew them as Species 8472. Many among my people want to know just what you did to make them hate us so. My patience is limited.
You probably made them hate us. Yeah, crackheads.
Doubt my word. Insult my honor. I have killed men for less. I have nothing to prove to the likes of you. Turn that so-called ambassador over to me now, or face the consequences. Turn over the shapeshifter, then we must destroy you.
Thank you. Great, now we got hazardous gas. Oh. Well, that's the part I have problems with. Yep. Ready. Of course there's Klingons. If it's not the pointy ear crack nuggets, we gotta fight the Klingons. You ever notice though, once you kill them, they don't disappear from radar? They don't go away. Oh, look, more Klingons. Hey, there was free stuff there. We had to grab the free stuff. Well, that's not the way we want to go. Oh, more free stuff. Another shiny. Woohoo! Free stuff!
Security forces have discovered the body of Ambassador Sokhen. They have determined that he was killed by a phaser blast at short range. His remains were discovered in a stasis chamber hidden in a cavern beneath the Ambassador's residence. The Ambassador on your ship, the one that I have been working for, is an imposter.
Oh great, it is a freaking shift changer. Shape changer thing.
He is crafty and very patient. Now that he has been discovered, he will be dangerous.
Thank you. Ugh. Great. Now he came down here. Face.
I see now my deception has been exposed. Pity. Capturing the abbot so we could replace him as well would have been beneficial. But we are strong. We will prevail. You are weak, and the weak shall perish. Trouble myself with such insignificant beings when the Klingons will do my work for me.
Oh, great. Now he's a Klingon.
Warriors, prepare for battle.
Yes.
There is a group of Starfleet officers behind me. One of them is the foul shapeshifter. I'm returning to the ship. Don't let them leave this planet alive. Goodbye.
Yes, sir.
Oh, a whole herd of them now. Well,
we're gonna die.
Told you we were gonna die. Holy crap.
This is Captain LaForge of the USS Challenger. Glad to see we made it here in time to lend you a hand. Perhaps you'll return the favor someday. LaForge out.
Well, poopy. At least we didn't die more than once. That makes for a good day when we don't die more than once.
The ambassador was an Undine? I'm afraid their infiltration of the Federation goes much deeper than we realized. Who knows what kind of havoc they could create?
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
Yay! To Earth we shall go. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard on Earth.
Security teams, report to docking bay 6.
This mission briefing is classified. I've been working with Starfleet Intelligence to crack the Undine coded message you found at Pajem. We think we have something. There are several references to the Pulsen Nebula in the data. Starfleet needs you to survey the nebula and find out why the Undine have an interest in it. Be careful. I've been in that nebula before. The composition of the clouds may screen opponents from your sensors. We need you in the Lackey system.
How do I know which ship I want now? And it's gonna cost me something. I don't think I can use tier 3, I think that's level 30. I think I was supposed to go see Boss Dude too while I was here. No, I don't need to go to the infirmary.
Captain Neth Parr has turned herself in to authorities at Deep Space Nine. She's the Zenkethi officer who delivered vital military intelligence to the Alliance prior to the assault on Bajor. Captain Parr is now actively seeking asylum and claims to have more tactical information for us. I'd like you to debrief the captain and determine the nature of this new information, if possible.
Woohoo! More missions! Okay, so we hold. And back to the ship we go. Oh yeah, we gotta leave. don't we have more than one quest? Did I jack up my operations here? I think I jacked up everything. But we had more than one quest. Maybe I just don't have a clue what I'm doing.
Your inventory has a replicator that allows you can purchase common items from the replicator. You can also sell items by using
aha! I did have another quest. Well, let's get this one done that we're on. Hey, look, it's Yoda and Obi-Wan. And Endor. Huh. Silly rabbit, that's the wrong movie.
Thank you for the assist. Our ship is on a mission to map the Pulsar Nebula. Unfortunately, we failed to adequately compensate for the power drain the nebula had on our engines. We retreated from the nebula to make repairs. That's when we stumbled upon an illegal Gorn mining operation. If you hadn't shown up when we did, we'd be sucking vacuum. Our chief engineer says there's no way we can make it back to a starbase. In fact, without new dilithium crystals, we're stuck. There are crystals on some of the larger asteroids here. That's why we headed for this location in the first place. If you could gather some crystals for us, we can make it to safety. Send us a hail if you have any questions about the nebula. We would be happy to share our data.
Time to go find some dilithium, I guess.
Yeah.
Come on. Now where'd that goofy ship go? Damn it. I think we're having problems here, folks. I want my ship turned. I think we're gonna die again.
Debt. This is enough lithium to get our warp engines restarted. After we finish preliminary repairs, we'll set course for Starbase 157. If you want to go into the Pulsar Nebula, your engines will need a boost. I recommend you visit Lackey 3. The Gorn drove out the Federation miners there and took over a decalithium processing facility. It's only fair that you take some of our crystals back.
Yeah, I just started last night, I think, on this game. Or early this morning, something. Yeah, this is one of my... Nah, Xbox. I could probably put it on my PC.
Target
Yeah, I made it myself. Actually, it runs on, let's see, my bot runs on. It's Scorp Bot. And then you just go in and set up your timers and stuff. Go to Scorp Bot. S-C-O-R-P. Bot website. And then I can set it up to run my Mixer, my YouTube, and my Twitch all at the same time. It talks on all of them. Wait, no, it doesn't talk on YouTube. And for some reason, it doesn't do Discord yet. It says it's coming soon. What am I looking for? Oh, the jamming station's up here on top of this rock. Thanks, you as well. I was watching videos earlier on YouTube, and they said you don't get no real good ships till like level 50. And that's where you can get serious with your ships. I guess till then we just sort of try to stay alive. I've decided, though, that streaming, I get more viewers on Twitch than I do on Mixer, which is really surprising, seeing I play on an Xbox. Maybe it's because I don't play PUBG, I don't get as many viewers on Mixer. just realized I'm out of Mountain Dew. No, not out of Mountain Dew. Beam me up, Scotty.
Well done. Starfleet will analyze the data from the listening post, and with luck, there will be something there that will help us in our fight against the Klingons.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
You have a new power that can be set up to automatically be used. Press the left trigger to show your powers. Use the left stick to navigate this radio menu. Navigate to brace for impact. Press RB to toggle between different auto-execute settings and change when this power will be automatically used. This power will be used even if it is not set up for quick equip.
We've decrypted some of the information you found at the Klingon listening post in the Paulson Nebula, and Starfleet Intelligence believes there is at least one more of those posts out there. We have the location.
Okay, let's get some of these missions complete. Is my ship moving? No. Travel. Auto-navigate. Wonder why it's not letting me auto-navigate. Because it wants me to spend all my money on transwarp stuff. Fly, Forrest, fly! Yes, I just started last night. Of course there's hostiles in the area. There's always hostiles in the area. I have some patience. With my luck, my batteries and my controller will go dead. They always do, in the middle of a big fight. I used to play this back when it first came out, and then I quit playing. Then I put it on my Xbox last night. Figured I'd try it on the Xbox rather than the PC. It's changed a lot since then. Emergency, emergency. Hold on, my phone's blowing up. Oh, okay, back to work. It's an Amber Alert going off. With the kind of weather we've had here today, thought maybe it's a tornado. I guess that's a different sound though when that goes off.
Just two more weeks. But then the semifinals are right upon us, and...
And 12 cases of Saurian brandy, 2 exterior mounted decorative flumes. One...
Klingons along the border of the sector. Redeploying tachyon sensors to pick up cloaked Klingon vessels.
Thank you. And back down to fight more stuff we go. What am I supposed to be doing here? Frickin'. Aha. Figured it out. Damn, blue bastards.
You have aided us in battle, and I respect your bravery. In honor of your actions against the Undine, we will not destroy you today. Next time, you will not be so fortunate.
Okay, now let's see what we can
do. Nice work out there. You're making quite a name for yourself in Starfleet.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
Starfleet has lost contact with the Federation science station in the Kasei system because all communications from Kasei 2 must be boosted by a satellite that compensates for Metreon isotopes prevalent in the system. It may be the communications array in need of repair. Please make the necessary repairs to the communications array and re-establish contact with the science station.
How come I have no frickin' energy credits?
On the front lines of the Klingon Federation War, brave captains from both sides battle to defend their homes and gain advantages for their faction. Each death has meaning. Every victory can turn the tide. These are the conflicts that will determine the fate of the Quadrant.
I don't understand that part of the operation. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. Let's go find Starfleet Academy. I am lost in space.
You Hidden dangers lurk in space, and the threat of Klingon attack has made even the most stout-hearted reconsider their choice to travel throughout the stars. A last-ditch effort to find a common ground could end this conflict, but there are many who oppose peace.
I think something's wrong with the game. I think it bugged out because it's not letting me go anywhere. Am I doing something wrong? Well, that didn't help none. I think the game's broke. Ooh. How the hell do I get there? Soul system. Thank you. Okay, now how do we get there? Where's my navigate thing? We'll go the old-fashioned way. What this thing's doing or how we do it, but hey, we just keep going. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Let's get our cool ship going again. Had to get me some water. Need to go to the store and buy more. Gotta drink the city stuff. I think we're making progress finally. Sheesh. I don't know if I am or not. What am I looking for? Hey, there's the system I need. I don't know why it wouldn't autopilot to it, though. I guess it just didn't want me to. Hey, look out, cadets. I'll run you over.
Oh, watch out, statue thing.
Big statue thing. Beam me up, Scotty.
Here we go again.
Where the hell do I get energy credits? What the hell is an energy credit? Thank you. Well, I am thoroughly confused. Well, poopy doo. Thank you. Well, poopy doo. Now what do we do? Okay, I gotta look at salt. While that ship does its thing. Yay, here we go. Finally, a mission. We are boldly going where no one has gone before. Okay. Probably a million people have gone before. And here we go again.
The Gorn. They just stormed in and started shooting. Not everyone. They're are several members of our team still unaccounted for. But go on.
Making damage detected.
Yay, beam down. Yep. Same people. It is us! That's what's wrong. We're coming to get you. We're gonna take you out. Well, I would, but I gotta go to work in 5 minutes. Real work, not sit around and play games work. The post office is sort of picky about playing games and working. Hopefully I can get this last mission, this part of the mission done. 4 minutes. Oh, this is not going to be good. I don't want to have to start this mission over.
If the archaeological sites in the Kassei system really are from a proto-Gorn culture, we will have to weigh carefully the knowledge we gain versus what the Gorn claim to be their own history. The Federation Science Council has a lot to consider. For now, though, I'm glad the researchers are safe. Good work.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
A representative from the Klingon Empire has agreed to meet with Maral Paris on Regulus IV. Lieutenant Paris is believed by some Klingons to be the Kuva Mach, a savior figure. That may or may not be the case, but if it means that the Klingons are willing to talk peace with Starfleet, we'll take the opportunity to do so. We need you to oversee security for the meeting. We have intelligence that there are Klingons who are against any sort of treaty, and we cannot allow them to disrupt the meeting. Go to Regulus IV and make sure that the location is safe.
Okay, everybody, that's another episode. We'll see you next time.